Well, howdy there, everybody. It's Katie Cable. I'm here with Olive the Pug, live on the farm for the weekly Runt Live Pharmaceuticals Edition, where I'm talking about farm-grown, natural, organic healing remedies for your pet. Okay, I'm going to lose the accent now. I've probably already lost all my viewers, but I'm going to talk about three things that should be in everybody's cupboard if you have a dog. And then for the proper dosing and a lot more items, you can go to weeklyrunt.weebly.com, click on the blog, and look for the pharmaceuticals blog for all the info and more tips, or follow me on Facebook, like my page, and click the link. So the first thing I want to talk about is the almighty coconut oil. This is extra virgin, cold press, organic coconut oil. You can get it at the market. Trader Joe's sells this big jar for about $6. This is great stuff. I add this healthy fat to Olive's food, but also if your pet has dry, flaky little noses or paws from the rough chill of winter, or their coat needs a little conditioning, you can apply this healthy fat as a lotion per se. That's one. The next thing is apple cider vinegar. This is awesome as an ear cleaning wash or as a spray for flea repellent. So you want to take apple cider vinegar, I get organic, again Trader Joe's, and you want to put it in a spray bottle with half apple cider vinegar, half water, and either you can dip a cotton ball in it and clean out your dog's ears, or you can spray them or your furniture before you go out for a walk or after you come in to repel fleas. And then there's a couple of other super easy great recipes with apple cider vinegar. You're just so excited to get in there. And finally, we have the can of pumpkin. Again, this was from Trader Joe's. Around the holidays, I always stock up on a ton of these cans of organic pumpkin. They're always on sale. And if you need to find a can in the middle of July, it's pretty tough. So go out and grab a can. And if your dog has either diarrhea or the runs, or they're circling, they're not going to the bathroom, they're constipated, a couple tablespoons. Again, my blog has all the dosing, but that will work to combat either diarrhea or constipation. Or if your dog is always hungry, loves to eat, you can also drizzle a little of the pumpkin on their food or mix it with their kibble or make treats with it. So I recommend, since usually if your dog has a bad bout, you are not going to go through a whole can unless you're feeding a whole rescue that got hit with diarrhea. So open the can, wait about 12 hours, give your pet a fast, and then put a few, maybe 3/4 of the can into ice cube trays. So that way, if it happens again, you can unfreeze them and you'll have a few servings in your freezer. All right, so thanks for watching, guys. Have a great week. Again, for all the information and a lot more tips, go to weeklyrunt.weebly.com or click on my Facebook page. And until next time, pugs and kisses. Come on, let's go.